You
guess when we were filming this one. You know what? That just made me realize. No. One of these days, we will be drunk for this, and you'll get more stories than you can possibly handle.
So in case you're wondering, welcome to the Shoot the Shit show. I'm Michael Angus Beef. I'm joined by Pun Master Jock, Jeff with one F,
and our last member, Magical Mystery Tyler.
Yes.
Yours, forget it. I know you do.
I do, of course.
You forget.
I forgot yours, Jeff, with
okay,
one F.
Okay, seriously, MMT. Easy acronym. He'll have the shirts. He's the one that we're...
You're going to get screamed at.
We're Von Lepping first.
And the only reason I remember Jeff's name is also his WoW name.
Wait, but will Roger Corman hit us for a Von Lep shirt? Or no?
No, it's in the public domain. They shouldn't even be touching it.
Von Bread and Sir Loaf are our creations.
Exactly. And it was used out of a public domain.
I'm only making like 4 shirts. Nobody's going to fucking be like,
well, no, that's the thing. If we wanted to sell shirts, we could, because it's in the public domain. He can't do shit.
Yep.
The only thing he did was flag our creation, and that's it. Like, he can't take anything else off, and if he does, like, I'll sue him.
We'll sue him, and then we'll get the publicity for it.
Exactly. I have no problems
publicity.
With that.
Yeah. It's the best form.
I will happily destroy the person I love.
What are you waiting for, Roger? Yeah, what the fuck are you waiting for?
Roger, we love you. Josh, the fuck up.
Why don't you make Death Race 4,000 already?
Actually, the sequel was pretty good.
It was good, but I want more.
Okay.
Roger!
Hi, we're doing more. Shoot the shit like we said.
Jeff, we want more.
Of going off the fucking rails.
So, that's the sequel show. Yeah, that's every show.
Rails.
We just go off the
Shooting
rails.
The shit off the rails is the crossover special.
Yes.
Off the rails is when we get drunk and do shit.
That's a good one.
There we
Actually,
go.
Actually, yeah, you just
there
pretty,
yeah.
Yeah.
Off the rails.
Anyway, Jeff has a story.
Jeff Genius!
Now I'm regretting. You're on levels of Justin and Gal Geiger annoying right now. Like, if you go and do Zoo Ranger every day and make me hate Sentai, I'm going to eat your chin.
Yum.
Like, not anything else. I just want that that little part under the lips.
Your cleft is mine, Jeff.
He has a cleft, and I think it gives him power.
Weirdo. All right, Jeff, I got to hear this story, man. What do you got for
it's
us?
It's not crazy, but you're just like, what the fuck? You
think I'm down for that.
You think it's Toronto?
Yeah.
Is this a Toronto story?
No.
Oh, okay.
You think it's Toronto because people here are getting really fucked up in Newmarket.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Don't come to Newmarket.
Oh, is this why you keep saying that? Did something happen in Newmarket?
Yeah. Like, you think the people, like, know shit of...
Not here, they don't.
Just anything normal. No.
Yeah, right.
I'm at Davis and Leslie, right? I'm just waiting for the bus.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's this guy that's going, like, on, like, pretty much right into the intersection, going on and off.
Yeah.
Onto oncoming traffic, trying to stop people.
So he's stopping traffic.
A pedestrian.
Pedestrian is trying to direct traffic, but not. It's like, what the fuck are you doing? He's literally going out there, just like, hands up, just like, stop. People are just like, what the fuck are you doing? It's like, okay, you can go. And I was like, what the fuck is this guy doing, man? He's doing this back and forth, and this guy doesn't give a fuck, and he nudges him and almost runs him over.
Fuck.
Oh, my God.
Going around him and shit. But this guy doesn't give a fuck. He goes back to his spot. Next light comes up. Oh, yeah, stop. Okay, go.
He wasn't trying to get anyone to pull over.
He wasn't trying to pull over anybody. He was just...
directing traffic.
What the fuck?
Did he have a gown on?
No. Here's this random guy with the fucking do-rag.
That's a crack addict, pal.
Yeah. No, they're definitely trying to get a spoon for their sugar, if you know what I'm saying.
Helps the medicine.
How
do you
get a spoonful of sugar stopping people? You're going to get a spoonful of fucking tire and ash?
No, when you get a spoonful of sugar when you light the lighter underneath it, is what we're saying.
Yeah, and Jeff.
It's the most delightful way.
Dun, dun, dun. No wonder all the toys in that song came to life. She was cracked making those kids do crutch. So the guy's stopping traffic.
Okay, like you know, on each other side of the road, they have this like little island that just separates
them.
Yeah,
yeah.
He's there. Like that's just like little fucking like. Okay, I'm gonna hide away for a second.
I'm gonna hide away and not get run.
Okay, guys, stop! Stop! Okay, go! What the fuck is he doing?
He might have been a mental patient from a home who legit thought he was going to be fucking... No, but here's the thing.
A random black guy smoking, listening to his tunes with a do-rag, directing traffic. What the fuck is going on?
Maybe his dad was a crossing guard who died in the line of duty, man.
Yeah. You ever think of that?
Yeah, just like Rick and Morty Ghost Train is like a fucking ghost crossing guard. Yeah. Just like, yeah, it's just like, you know those little signs that light up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Lights up, creates a fucking dimension, just like, go through. Like, what the fuck?
Ferrying all the kids to their afterlife school.
Fuck. That's you know what? It's not surprising. There's a place down the street from my
Yeesh.
Work where it's a mental home. People, even where I live, there's a mental home. They just walk
there
around.
Is a mental home in your
they
place.
They let them. They
Isn't
let
there
them.
Like a hospice, like fucking.
There's two of them down the street,
like
from where I live
or something.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. There is a hospice right near the school, actually. And it's probably, honestly, dude, like, towns like these, they let those people run around and get fresh air for a reason. They go home and get nursed all day.
Yeah.
Some of them milk it. Some of them fucking fake it. Like, it's...
I should fake that fucking...
There's shit. One weird motherfucker near my work who is a guy who says he literally refuses to wear anything but leggings. Yeah. And I want a projectile vomit on him every time I see him.
Like that, though.
I would still fucking puke on him every time. Because this guy is...
Tyler, what do you think?
Goddamn weird.
Leggings on man.
Leggings on man? I mean, if the man's girly enough, maybe I can get an erection off of
him. Fuck off with this topic! Fuck off with this topic. We're done. Jeff had a story about a weird guy.
Let's
it's
rate
all
it before,
over.
Before yeah.
Oh,
let's
oh,
rate
oh.
it.
Everybody relax. Holy shit.
You know what? Because of how you did it, I'm giving that like a 7.5.
You
actually told
six,
that very good.
I would give you a
6.5.
Very well. You told that goodly.
7, yeah.
Yes,
welly.
You told that welly.
Tyler, what would you give?
No, 7 is also my score as well, because 7 is my worth it to hear.
Okay.
Oh, way to put on the fucking band, man.
Real quick,
Tyler.
Though, I have to ask then, what was my getting roofied story worth?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
We didn't review that.
Your roofie story is at least an 8. The other reason I'm taking off the 2 different points is
9.5 for harsh truths.
Well, hang on, like, let me hear Tyler's reasoning.
Yeah, no, because it's just like you only got roofied.
No, you only got roofied. You only got raped.
So
it's
next
okay.
time you guys do it, can you kill me so my story has a little more impact?
It's not like
yeah,
they,
absolutely.
I'll kill you right
sorry,
now, goddamn. Just shut up.
I'm sorry, but it's not like they made the hangover of your story, so that's why I'm giving it an 8.
To be fair, though, at the same time, I didn't even feel anything, so yeah, I guess that's fair.
To be fair, you're all fucked up. Thanks for watching our shit. Zoo Ninja! Zoo Ninja! Get out of the fucking...